Welcome back to Newswatch. Well, Matt, I know we got a decent amount of rain yesterday, well, at least we did here, but it wasn't enough to get us out of the woods, right?
Just enough to like get the ground wet, but we are in a moderate drought for all of southern West Virginia. It's slowly growing. We've seen probably so far the driest month of September on record. How about that? A little fun fact. But let's talk about the tropics. I'll talk about more of that, about that drought in just a little bit. But we right now we have a monster of a storm, Hurricane Lorenzo. It has sustained winds at 145 miles an hour. Very large storm. The good news is it has no impacts to the United States. It's just a very large hurricane. Very strong storm as well, but that's going to stay off in the deep Atlantic Ocean. But another storm to keep an eye on is Tropical Storm Karen. Right now has sustained winds at 45 miles an hour. It's going to make a sharp left turn and head towards the United States. The good news is that this storm does have a sign of weakening. It will become a low pressure system by next week. So keep our fingers crossed for that storm. But for your morning's commute, we are seeing a little bit of patchy fog. If we take a look at our visibility, we're seeing about 4 miles of visibility, some light patchy fog around Bluefield and Princeton. But down south to Richlands, Virginia, there's some very dense patchy fog. Areas, especially north of the I-64 corridor, not too much fog for us this morning. Temperatures are a little cooler compared to yesterday, in the 50s, but don't worry, we're gonna get much warmer this afternoon. If we take a look at the Doppler radar, things are very dry. That's good news for us, a few little clouds here and there. And here's what's going on. We have a high pressure system off to our east. This is gonna bring more warmer and also a little bit more muggier conditions. Our winds are gonna come out from the southeast for us. So again, it's gonna feel like summer for us today. We have a weak cold front off to our west that's gonna push in. That might bring us some isolated showers on Saturday, but this high pressure system is pretty much gonna stay anchored off to the east. So we're gonna continue to stay on the muggy side. If you take a look at your muggy forecast, if you take a look as we get through probably this afternoon, we're gonna be borderline to muggy and humid. So the summer heat is returning. If you take a look at the 5-day temperature trend, we're gonna be in the mid 80s this weekend, very hot and muggy and steamy. So definitely have the ACs cranked on for the next 5 days. Here's our current drought monitor. Like what I said earlier, we're now in a moderate drought for all of southern West Virginia. And here's what their month of September's look like. We've only seen 4 days of rain for us. You know how much our rain total was? A tenth of an inch of rain, all right? Do you know what an average month of rain we'll see in September? 3 inches of rain. We are the driest month of September on record. Now, right now, if September ended, we would be number one. But we still have four more days to see if we'll get any rain. Hopefully we do. We desperately need it. If you take a look at your hour-by-hour forecast, we're going to stay dry and warm, temperatures in the 80s. Tonight's forecast, a great night for high school football. Clouds be clearing, mostly clear skies. Temperatures be comfortable around the mid-60s. If you do want to have a bonfire, it's a great night for it, but I really don't think we should burn just because we're in a moderate drought and that could spread some fires. So highly not recommend it. Tomorrow's forecast, partly cloudy skies, but we will see a few little isolated showers on that cold front. Temperatures will stay very warm, almost like summer for us, summer round three in the 80s. If you take a look at your Senate forecast, we are staying very hot and warm for the next 7 days.